CRADLE. Lost in the abyss of stasis, I floated in a world where time seemed both endless and non-existent. The only tether to reality were the sporadic bursts of dream and memory that danced on the periphery of my consciousness. "Will we remember each other?" a soft voice stirred in my mind. "We will remember," I assured. A slender feminine figure was beside me, barely perceptible, the light from the bedside lamp masking her face as my fingers stroked her delicate cheek. "You won't forget me." The voice was more insistent as fleeting images intertwined. Long raven hair cascading down her naked back, fingers entwined, the distinct imprint of a small blue butterfly tattoo on the back of her shoulder. "I won't forget you," I again assured. I leaned in to secure the promise with a kiss when a sensation of movement tugged at me. The cradle, mankind's greatest and perhaps final technological marvel, left its orbit and began its slow descent into the virgin atmosphere. My body, in stasis, was unable to witness the most monumental event in mankind's history. Its rebirth from extinction,